Ever wondered if chicken droppings could be turned into high quality organic fertilizer?
Yeah, currently it is on market and farmers are buying.
Today we are diving into the science behind transforming poultry waste into a cost-effective, eco-friendly fertilizer.
These droppings from the bird, they undergo complete decomposition. The moment you apply it, it starts releasing the nutrients.
How does it dry so fast? What about the pathogens? And is it safe for crops?
Actually, we dry it, but we don't remove the effluent.
In this video, we are breaking it all down, plus showing you the machine that makes it all possible.
When you have dug your hole, you put half of this spread, then you smash it around.
Before they were using that dryer to dry these droppings, but what's happening is that they put this shrub to make sure that this assists the process of drying or squeezing the moisture out of these droppings. So this is actually makes the whole process quicker and easier. So most of you who do not have dryers, you can actually like build a shrub, like a surface like this one, and then you get those droppings and you keep drying them under the sun. Of course, I'm back at Jeka and I'm just going to give you an update on what's happening at this facility where they are turning droppings into organic fertilizer. But he's going to give us the scientific bit of it. Last time we just talked about it like on surface, because I remember most of you were asking, isn't the time too short? How do you kill the pathogens, something like that? What happens? Doesn't it lose its value? How do you deal with pathogens? So he's going to answer such questions. Mr. Rashid, you're welcome once again.
Thank you, madam.
When I was here, this wasn't there.
Yeah, it was not there. Actually, it was established to facilitate drying. Because initially you found out that you could collect the manure from the cage and directly put in the what? In the solar dryer.
Yeah, yeah.
That structure there. Mm-hmm. And in the solar dryer entirely, it removes the 70% of the moisture content.
Okay.
So the remaining 30%, it is being dried from the floor, as you can see on this shrub.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. So it was established to enhance.
To
enhance the drying. Because the moment it is collected from there, when it is partially dried, here it only takes 3 days when it is dry, and then it is grinded, ready for molding to make organic fertilizer.
So the question is, how are you dealing with, are they called pathogens without compromising on the...
Okay. First of all, the quality of the nutrients, they are not compromised. We don't remove, actually we dry it, but we don't remove the effluent. We call it effluent.
Mm-hmm.
The effluent dries within
okay. The
manure, but it is not removed. And it is the effluent that contains the nutrient itself. And we don't add anything to do with the chemical. That means it is natural. And if you have applied in the soil, it does not deplete the soil. It maintains the soil fertility for a long period of what? Of time. As it improves also the soil structure.
Before the other innovations that have come around, they were using this machine to squeeze out, you know, that moisture from the droppings. But later on, they realized that the more they were squeezing out the moisture, they were compromising, they were tampering with the nutritional content in these droppings. And so they had to abandon this machine. I was just amazed at how someone is genuinely dedicated to making sure that they are producing the best at its best.
Yes.
What if these droppings had diseases like?
Of course, these droppings may contain the what? The disease. But the process it passes through, it tries to reduce the chances of what? Transmitting the disease. For example, in the mold itself, it is subjected to higher temperatures by the power. And it is enough to, you know, to pasteurize and kill the microorganisms. Yes.
The process, you said it takes how long?
The whole drying can take a week.
Because there
it spends around 4 days, then here around 3 days.
So those are 7 days.
Seven days.
Isn't it too hot to burn the plants, if I may use layman's language?
No. Now, these droppings from the birds, they undergo complete decomposition. It is not partially decomposed, it is complete decomposition. The moment you apply it, it starts releasing the nutrients because it is fully decomposed. So it does not burn the plant, unlike manure from the cow, from the cattle.
Interesting. So the other thing was about those machines there. Yes.
Now you can see that there is a grinder there, and this grinder, the moment the manure is dried, as you can see here, it is already dry. It is brought up here in the grinder and grinded to make the size particles that can easily be molded by the molder. This is the molder. So the moment it is collected from there, it is brought in the molder to make pelleted fertilizer, which is later collected. And it is spread on this floor to allow heat dispersion, because it is produced with a lot of heat. There is a lot of heat here. So it is spread there to remove that heat. Then later it is packed in 50 kgs and 25 kgs, ready for marketing.
Where do I get this machine?
That machine can be got anywhere. It can be fabricated. It's all about having a design. Even in Kenya, they can produce them. Yeah, they can fabricate them.
So anyone, if you are not in Uganda, if you're in Uganda, this can be fabricated from Kenya.
Yeah, because apart from the molder. The molder is imported. Yeah,
from
this one was imported from China.
Okay.
Yes.
So if you're not in Uganda, still there is hope for you. We'll share the design of this machine. You make sure you have watched all the series of Jeka, then you'll be able to access this design of this molder. I mean this grinder, so that you can make it from your country. All right, it takes me to my other question. How are people finding it? Are they buying the... Because last time I was here, it wasn't on market yet.
Yeah, currently it is on market and farmers are buying. The good thing with this fertilizer, it is applicable in whichever field of agronomy. Be it banana field, be it coffee field, be it horticulture, you know? Be it, you know, sugarcane plantation, it is applied anyway. We have not realized the any adverse effect from those people who are using it. And they are just plowed.
So how do
you can imagine a 50 kg at 50,000 shillings. Yes. It is relatively, you know, it is a fair price.
Yeah, it's fair.
Yes.
So how do I use that fertilizer?
The fertilizer, it entirely depends on the field.
Maybe we can, Gandhi, you show us how we can use it. Because some people are wondering, what do I do, like for banana farmers?
Banana farmer
and coffee farmers, they first dig those holes.
They dig the holes, and then after digging, you can have a half of this spade.
Okay.
Yeah, half of this spade of this pelleted fertilizer. Then you spread it around in the, you know, in the pond.
When you have dug your hole.
Yeah, when you have dug your hole, you put half of this spade. Then you smash it around the pond.
Okay.
Then you cover with little soil. Then you put your what?
Immediately, I shouldn't wait.
Immediately, there's no problem. There's nothing like to do with, you know, waiting for fermentation.
Okay, so this is actually beautiful.
Then for maize, you get a lid of Mobiti jerry is enough in
each hole of maize.
Each hole of maize.
So I was saying this is actually a good substitute for those fertilizers that take like a month. Yeah. Someone digs a hole, they take a break of 1 month.
And even these inorganic fertilizers, when you look at DAP or CAN, what, you see?
They are not organic.
They are not organic, they are inorganic. For example, for those fertilizers like the CAN, when you apply it in the field, it requires it to apply it periodically, okay? But here you can put in this season, and the next season, even if you don't put, the soil will not be depleted. Because it improves on soil structure. Yes, it improves on soil what? Soil structure. And it is balanced. You know, the little bit of science with these droppings, it contains more of urea. And in urea, they dissolve a lot of nitrogen compounds. A lot of nitrogen compounds, which are nutrients for the crop. And they are responsible for vegetative growth. The vegetative growth growth of any plant is entirely dependent on that.
And that's a wrap on our update. Kindly get yourself this fertilizer if you're out there and you are promoting organic farming. It's very, very cheap. I'm not advertising. For me, who is passionate about farming, you know, I believe this is a good solution and you should have one for yourself. Thank you so much.
And cost effective.
It's cost effective, yes. Yeah. And that's it's time saving. Yes. It's effective in all ways.
Yeah.
All right, thank you so much. That's it for organic fertilizers.